Right now we are on top of the Portuguese fortress that they built way back when over Luanda. Bom dia from country 144, Angola. I say bom dia because this is a Portuguese-speaking nation with so much life and character that nobody really knows about. Why? Angola went through a long and brutal civil war from 1975 to 2002, and until now, that's the reputation the country has. But there's so much more to the story, and a thriving life does exist here. Up until 6 months ago, Angola was one of the hardest countries to visit because the government nearly blocked tourism. But now, a new e-visa makes life super easy to get in. It's surreal to be in a place that much of the outside world doesn't know about, but I love it. A local friend who I met through social media, José, has been showing me around the capital of Luanda, which is home to about one-third of Angola's 28 million people. Luanda is a city of contrasts, a city of surprises.
There's casually a fire in the trash over here.
So we just walked through an entire market and it ends at the sea right here. This monument behind me was started by the Soviets in 1982 and completed by the North Koreans in 2012. There's a long coastline of beautiful beach alongside crazy busy streets with police patrolling on every block. At times, I feel safe. Other times, I feel unsafe. Let's just say I get a lot of attention on the streets because people are not used to seeing tourists. Every corner you look is something different. People selling anything they can get their hands on, like bananas or t-shirts. You can find shoe shiners and car washers working on sidewalks directly under modern skyscrapers. There are plenty of nice cars on the roads, like expensive nice, yet most of the houses are shanties like you see here. What I quickly realized is that you either have money or you don't. There is not much of a middle ground. Angola's economy has grown rapidly over the last few decades.
The skyline changed very rapidly
because of the discovery of oil, but its infrastructure hasn't been able to keep up, resulting in Luanda being the world's most expensive city for expats and tourists. More on that in another video. I kind of like the fact that nobody knows anything about this country because it makes discovering everything more interesting and exciting. I cannot wait to tell you more stories inside this hidden country called Angola.